Friends, now we are going to see construction of NPN transistor, which has N semiconductor followed by P semiconductor and again N semiconductor. Means it consists of three terminals, base, emitter and collector, along with three semiconductors NPN. So let's draw that. Suppose this P semiconductor is base. Then remaining two terminals will be emitter and collector respectively. But we can see that there are two semiconductors which are of same type. Those are N semiconductor and again N semiconductor. So while constructing BJT, we need to see their width as well as doping level. Based upon that, we can have emitter and collector at different side. Because if both are N semiconductors, then how to differentiate between emitter and collector? That is the main point while we are going to construct BJT. Let's see that. In BJT, emitter will have medium width, whereas collector will have maximum width. What is the reason behind it, students? Now see that, as name is given as collector, it is going to collect all the majority carriers. So it requires more area. Whereas emitter is going to emit all the electrons away from the junction. So it does not require maximum area, but yes, it requires at least medium width or medium area. Hence, emitter is having medium width, whereas collector is having maximum width. This is how I can differentiate between collector and emitter. The next is base. What about base? Actually, base does not require more area, but yes, it requires some amount of doping level. Now see that I'm going to construct BJT depending upon their area. What we want is collector should have maximum area. Next, base will have minimum area. And emitter will have medium area. Now see this. This is NPN transistor. This is N, P, N. Whereas this P terminal is nothing but base terminal. As area given to this N semiconductor is highest, it is called as collector. Whereas area given to this semiconductor is medium. Hence, it is called as emitter. Now, we'll see doping level of these three regions. What is doping level in collector, emitter and base? Now, we can see that emitter has or it has to provide electrons for the current. It should have maximum amount of doping, because it is giving electrons for the conductions. So it has maximum amount of doping. Whereas collector is collecting the carriers. Are you getting this? Emitter is giving the carriers, whereas collector is collecting the carriers. So collector is mediumly doped. So I can say that emitter is having maximum amount of doping, whereas collector is having medium amount of doping. So we can see that, or we can show that with the help of majority carriers and minority carriers. In N semiconductors, electrons are majority carriers. So whereas in collector, This is how doping level is different in emitter and collector, where emitter is having maximum amount of doping, whereas collector is having medium amount of doping. This is how we can construct BJT. But in base, the majority carriers will be holes. So we will show that. Now this is construction of BJT having different width for emitter, base and collector, as well as different doping levels of majority carriers of respective semiconductors. This is NPN type of BJT and its construction. Thank you, friends.